Back in an effort to preserve Native American culture, traditions, and heritage, Whitney Rencountre, CEO of the Crazy Horse Memorial Foundation, joins me now to talk about his position and the mission of Crazy Horse and what this mission means to the Native American community. So nice to see you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, Whitney, you are, and I want to get this right, you are Crow Creek Hunkpati. Right? Dakota.
Correct.
From the Crow Creek Sioux Tribe.
Crow Creek,
okay.
Yes.
Crow Creek Sioux Tribe, okay. And also you are CEO of the Crazy Horse Memorial Foundation.
Yes.
It's wonderful to have you. We are going to start having discussions once a month. I'm so excited about that. But you are also known even more than just coming on our show. You are really a bridge builder in the community. Mm-hmm. What is your vision for these segments, these monthly segments?
Yeah, absolutely. I think especially locally, when we have places in our communities in the Black Hills that do that work, the work continues even
right
absent of the tourist season. We don't really get appreciation of what everyone's doing across the Black Hills. And at Crazy Horse Memorial, you know, we work so hard to protect and preserve the culture, tradition, living heritage of North American tribes. And we feel like it's just important for us to share how we advance our mission at Crazy Horse Memorial. So we're really excited to be here and to be joining you monthly.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's what I do want to talk about, your mission. You know, what's so interesting is when you do visit and you are an outsider, like I was,
yes,
for a while when I first came, it is spectacular. It does give you this incredible feeling when you are on that mountain. It is one of inspiration. But speak to us about, I know it's so much more than just a visitor coming and saying, wow, this is so incredible of a carving.
Sure.
But tell me what the mission really is at Crazy Horse Foundation.
Well, I think Chief Henry Standing Bear, who had the idea to honor his first cousin, Crazy Horse, Tashunke Witko, who Crazy Horse is known, widely known as one of the greatest individuals amongst our people, because he protected the grandmothers, the mothers during a time of battles. And during the Battle of Little Bighorn, he was the leader that helped defeat Custer during that time. And so his first cousin wanted to honor him. And during a time that the termination era in our country, the government wanted everybody to be a melting pot, everyone to speak the same language, everyone to be the same. So Chief Henry Standing Bear had this idea that if he invited Korchak Chilkovsky to come help carve this mountain in honor of Crazy Horse, that the people, no matter what happened to Native American culture, mm-hmm, people from all over the world will be attracted here and they'll learn more about our history, language, traditions. And so that is why the memorial was started.
Okay. We have there's so much more to really expand with this subject. We have 30 seconds. What is your vision at this point for, obviously the monthly segments and Crazy Horse, as you are the CEO of the foundation?
Well, being a CEO is such a privilege and an honor. And coming from a reservation here in South Dakota and going to college at Spearfish Black Hill State, now being the CEO,
yes,
and it really is an opportunity for us to share more about the work of Crazy Horse Memorial. And I think it's just important for us. We do better when we know better.
Absolutely.
And a lot of people do not know a lot about Native people's tradition, history, culture. And so we're going to continue to share the work of Crazy Horse Memorial, not only here on KOTA territory, mm-hmm, but throughout, and to continue to share the message that people should learn more and have a better understanding of Native American culture.
Okay, wonderful. Well, I look forward to learning more and more, from the East Coast. You don't learn as much, unfortunately, but I look forward to it. Thank you so much, Whitney, for being here.
Thank you.
All right, meteorologist Eric Garner says the fog and low clouds